evening, everybody. Glad you've made the decision to be with us. Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. We're glad to be bringing you action and welcoming you to the Metro Manila Arena here in the Philippines. Our main event should be a good one tonight. 12 rounds in the heavyweight division. We are looking forward to this fight, especially after seeing what happened at the weigh-in yesterday. A stare down that nearly resulted in a bout breaking out right there. Now they get to do it for real.
We went over the rules in the dressing room. Let's have a good, clean fight. Touch them up.
This is a 12-rounder. Here's round number one. And there he is, scoring with the right hand. Blocks it away. Comes with the straight right hand. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Halfway through round number one. You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. Fighters do. Pulls the trigger right away after taking one. Dynamite's just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores.
Keep working the body.
Last 10 seconds. This round comes to an end. A round in which this fighter threw a lot of punches, didn't land a lot of punches. I'll tell you, what advice can you give to him if you're the trainer?
Well, first of all, deal with the psychological part. Joe, don't forget, 75% of this game is psychological. Don't let him get discouraged, because even though he's not going to say nothing, in his head he's starting to get discouraged. Just say to him, hey, listen, you're going to catch him. Let's shorten him up a little bit. And you know what? He's moving his head, so go to the body. Because now you're going to hit him a little in the body, because the body's not moving.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Comes with the right. He is damaged badly there. He may hit the floor. Good effective work with that straight right hand. Reaching the halfway mark of this round. He got all into that one. That was a solid uppercut.
Keep doing what you're doing.
Banking away a body shot with the right hand. Hmm. And now he scores with that left to the body. Good defense, just covering up down low. Final 10 seconds of round number two. This round comes to an end. And Teddy, easy to note here that he wasn't landing a lot of punches. Now he was throwing them up, but he wasn't landing a lot. Is that because of his opponent's defense, or is he just not that accurate of a puncher?
No, it's a combination. First of all, his opponent's pretty slick in there, pretty good at bobbing, weaving a little bit, slipping a little bit, making himself a difficult target, but his punch is a little wide. Needs to shorten him up.
I want to see that counter hook. Make him pay for his mistakes. Listen, you're not giving me enough.
Well, he got caught by a lucky punch in that last round. It did do some damage, but now you can tell he's right back where he wants to be, fresh and ready as we start this round.
I don't take lightly when a guy gets dropped, but you know what? I think he was more embarrassed than he was hurt.
Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own.
Work the body.
He missed with that headshot. Able to cover up along the belt line, blocks that one. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. Good step back counterpunch there.
Beautiful.
And he's really doing a nice job of hitting the mark with the jab.
And that's exactly what he needs. And it's not hard to hit the mark when the mark's coming at you. The right choice of a punch.
Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Well, earlier you saw what happened to him. He was stunned. He got tagged in this fight. He got hit hard. Now you're seeing the kind of mentality that's going to try to avoid that happening again. But, Teddy, it's not necessarily the kind of mentality that's going to win you a fight.
No, if you're in the corner with him, you know what you tell him, Joe? You tell him, look, you're being tested now. I understand you've been hurt. I understand you're looking to survive right now. But you're being tested for the first time in your life. Do you want to be a champion? Do you want to be special? Special people find a way to get out of this and still offensively go forward.
He's got to answer those questions. And round three comes to an end.
Okay? I want to see that counter hook. Make him pay for the mistakes. Listen, you need to make your
nice and relaxed. Good, good. This is what I need you to do. Keep shooting a jab to his chest. His hand.
Always good to get off to a good start, and that's exactly what he's done tonight on Teddy's scorecard, sweeping the first three rounds. Dynamite's going to think about the next time he throws a punch because he just got hit by a good, solid counter. Oh, what a whiff by Dynamite. Right hand downstairs. Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. Well, he goes to the gut with a right hand. Just hugging there. Took a shot. Now he gives a left. Good right hand. Halfway through round number four. Blocks the headshot. Hands up. Great movement to get away from those punches. Blocks that punch. A clean, crisp right hand by Dynamite.
Uppercut.
Showing you some defense there with the block. 10 seconds to go in the fourth.
Watch the hook.
You're looking good. Looking good. He's tired. Look at him. He's so fucking tired. He's got nothing left. Now listen to me. I need you to double up your punches and keep the lead, all right?
Beautiful. Trickle. Don't stand in front of him. I need you to throw the punches. Body, bang, the body, hit the body.
Round number 5 has arrived. Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time him, he can counter him.
He just missed that shot up top. And now just wasting everybody's time holding on. Well timed by Dynamite. He took a step back, landed the counter punch.
Exactly what he wanted to do.
Still plenty of time to work here in round number 5. Minute and a half to go.
Body shots.
Now he ties up there. And he returns on that exchange. Good jab by Dynamite. A good block. He's got that certain something that's a well-acquired skill in this craft of boxing. And that is superb defense, and it's on target tonight.
It is. The old-timers would say, you know, that's the hard thing, is to learn defense. You know, the easy part, the fun part, is let your hands go. So he's got the hard part down. Guess what? He's enjoying the fun part right now because of it.
Really nice round out of him right there. And we haven't been able to say that much. I think that was by far one of his better efforts. He won that last round. He is trailing on the scorecards, but I do believe he won that last round.
Yeah, well, what I like the most is he could have easily, you know, he could have capitulated a little bit. He could have, you know, spit the bit a little bit. You're not supposed to, but hey, these are human beings. They do it. He could have gotten frustrated. He's not. He's got himself together. He's acting like a pro. He's doing what he needs to do to get back in his race. Or back in this fight.
Back to action here at the start of this round. That last round was very interesting because it was the kind of round that can turn a fight in a completely new direction. He did well.
Yeah, you know, the old time saying was bad start, good finish. Well, that's what he's hoping for, good finish.
A shooting right hand by Dynamite.
Good. More punches. Guard up.
Dynamite's making for a tough target there. He gets away from that punch. Distance, such a key factor always, Teddy, when it comes to defense. With his good foot movement, he's been keeping that distance. His opponent, how does he close that gap properly?
Well, first of all, he's got to use his jab to close it because he's getting picked off coming in. He's getting pot-shotted. So he's got to have something coming at his opponent that keeps him distracted. Use that jab. Now, Don't use it conventionally, Joe. You're jabbing at the head, you're not finding nothing. You're just finding space. So jab a little lower. Drop the sights a little bit. Jab at his chest. Just so you touch something, and then you can work your way in. You can start to find them a little.
Now his opponent got away from that uppercut. Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. Working our way towards the bell. Last 10 seconds of the sixth. Well, if the second half of this fight is anything like the first half we just witnessed, then, oh boy, is it going to be fun watching this fight down the stretch.
And I don't think it can change. These guys came here with a certain attitude, a certain mindset, and it's not going to be able to change now. There's no way of all of a sudden in mid-fight being able to go to a defensive fight or a different strategy. What you see is what you get, and you're going to get it the rest of the night.
There you go.
Where's your body work? Hit the body.
Good action throughout. We'll see if it keeps up in this round of what has been a very even fight. Great job of protecting himself. He's keeping his guard up very, very well. Teddy, does it help to have the speed that he has?
Sure. Anytime you have speed and you can put it into the equation where whatever you're doing, it has to be technically right, but now you put speed, you're doing it even better. You're doing it at a higher level.
At the halfway point of round seven.
Use the jab.
And now you can see him utilizing the jab.
You know, a lot of times you see a guy on the outside bouncing around, staying away. You understand the use of a jab. But when you're coming forward, you have to come forward with a cover. And that jab, that's the cover.
And you can see he wanted to do that as he holds on there. Turns over that hook and he does damage upstairs. And that's the end of round seven.
Thank you. Keep it up. You guys never felt the beat like this.
We got it.
Keep the pressure up.
Oh, this is a wipeout. You're winning this fight. Just keep doing what you're doing, and you got this. Just keep doing what you're doing.
You gotta watch the
Listen,
water in the corner.
I want you to pick his jabs. When he throws a jab.
Let's look at Teddy's scorecard as we start this eighth round. And I think this tells pretty much the story. Yeah, he's got a slight lead. However, there have been those moments where you see a defensive flaw.
Yeah, the other guy's coming on fast. The defensive flaw is that he covers up too much. He blocks too many punches. And when you're blocking too many punches, while the guy puts punches together, some are going to get through. Some are getting through.
Missed the target with that hook.
Come on, kid, focus. Relax.
Dynamite's putting a smile on his corner man's face right there and frustrating his opponent with that jab. 90 seconds to go, halfway through round eight. Dynamite's throwing a lot of punches right here, but not a lot of them are landing.
And that can be very discouraging to the guy who's throwing them, because he's working, but he's starting to get a little frustrated, a little concerned that he's not doing damage, as you said.
Solid left hand scored by Dynamite.
You're not pace yourself.
Good looking uppercut that time. End of the round. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas with you ringside. He just didn't throw enough, Teddy. I mean, you got to go out there and put something forth if you want to win the round.
Hey, sometimes it's complicated. Sometimes it's pretty simple. You don't throw punches, you don't win fights.
Okay, listen to me. When he misses you with a punch, counter. Counter. Listen, he's done. He's done. I'm really wanting
good action here tonight. Both guys bringing their best, and both guys meeting each other stride for stride, punch for punch. Tough fight to score here as we're back underway. Good right hand by Dynamite. Gets rid of that effort. And he engages in the clinch. Seconds into the ninth round. See, the defense pays off as he gets rid of that downstairs. Last 10 seconds of the ninth round. Not able to land the headshot. All right, Teddy, let me put you back in your old job here. You're going to be trainer here. Now, we're just coming off of a round there. We're clearly, I think he won the round, but it's a close competitive fight that your guys probably win.
Yeah, I know what not to tell him. I'm not telling him he's winning. That's what I'm not telling him. I want to make sure that he keeps his edge. You know, he stays smart and everything, but the only reason that I think he's up is because he's keeping the punch output. He's staying sharp defensively. You know, he's still attacking in the spots that he should attack. I want to keep it that way.
Back to live action now in what has been a closely contested fight. One of those fights that somebody is still waiting to break through and be a difference maker in.
Punch. Keep working, Jeff. Double up your punches.
Hook. Dolomite's given us a good showcase of defense here tonight, especially up top. His head movement is just sublime.
And his opponent's cooperating with him a little bit because he's getting frustrated. He's looking.
Could this be the start of a big comeback? He went from owning this fight to now nearly down and out.
You know, that's what makes boxing so great. Yes, you can come back just like that. One punch at the right time. That was at the right time.
He returned fire right there, and it worked. After being rocked, now he gets his man.
At this point, it's not about the skills and the abilities of these two fighters. It's about the dreams of them, and one of them is being eliminated.
How about that left right there? And that's the end of round 10.
Okay, you're okay. Keep your hands up. You can keep them up, all right? I mean, you know, he caught you with your hands down. Let's keep them up. Listen, he's gonna come forward this round, all right? Keep that jab moving. Keep him away from you, all right?
This is it. You heard it. Keep on it. Okay, man. Beautiful.
I'm sure as a trainer, when you get in a spot like this, there's extra emphasis of letting your charge know just what he's capable of pulling off. I look at your scorecard, he's only trailing by a very small margin here in round number 11.
Well, the key right now as a trainer, and you just touched on it, you have to remind your charge, your fighter, of why he's doing it. Things that he understood when it was nice and calm, when everything was very understandable, when he told you in the gym, hey, I want to be champion. You got to remind him of that and say, okay, here's your chance. Here's your moment.
Protect the midsection. Dynamite! Feeling the sting of that big uppercut. 90 seconds to go in this 11th round.
There you go.
He's all over the place. I mean, he's missing punches. Yeah, he's throwing punches, but he's missing just about everything he throws.
Well, we look up top. You know, we look at the punches going away. They're going left, they're going right, they're going all over the place. But look downstairs. His feet are not set. He's falling all over the place. And guess what? The punches follow where his feet are.
Good return fire that time. And now just wasting away some time with that clinch. Oh, he just misses with that headshot.
Keep working the body.
And clicks of the talk.
You need to keep that head moving.
This round comes to an end. A round in which this fighter threw a lot of punches, didn't land a lot of punches. I'll tell you, what advice can you give to him if you're the trainer?
Well, first of all, deal with the psychological part. Joe, don't forget, 75% of this game is psychological. Don't let him get discouraged, because even though he's not going to say nothing, in his head he's starting to get discouraged. Just say to him, hey, listen, you're going to catch him. Just shorten him up a little bit. And you know what? He's moving his head, so go to the body. Because now you're going to hit him a little in the body, because the body's not moving.
They have reached the 12th and final round.
Pace yourself.
Beat him to the punch.
If that keeps up, this is going to be a good night. The right hand scored by Dynamite.
Keep Keep moving. Keep moving.
And just grabbing on to his opponent. That's a big uppercut that just crashed home. Halfway through this 12th and final round.
Hello!
All right, here we go. Last 60 seconds of the fight.
Double him up.
Here's one for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand.
I can imagine throughout your career, you've been all over a lot of fighters for lack of movement.
Yeah, it's very, very frustrating because you start to wonder, does he want to win the fight? That's what you start to wonder.
Seconds to go in this, the final round.
Keep pushing.
From start to finish, it was utter domination.
This was an easy one to score, Joe.
As for that expected outcome, we send it up to the ring to hear from the judges. So a unanimous decision win by Dynamite. That's the way we saw it all night long. The judges agree.
It was hard to see it any other way.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Thanks for being with us ringside.